In this video, I will show you how you can encrypt or decrypt a series of numbers. Let's say credit card numbers, phone numbers, social security numbers. I'm using social security numbers. And so what I do here is I use a formula to encrypt it and then decrypt it. It's a very simple algorithm. I did that on purpose, so if you ever use this for illegal purposes, law enforcement can decode it easily. So what is it based on? It's based on the fact that every character, including numbers, have a certain ASCII number. So what I put here to just show you what it does, I go 1, 2, 3, 4, and I do that up to 125 or something like that. And then I'm going to use the function character based on G1, and I copy that formula down so it shows me what that icon or letter or character stands for in ASCII numbers. You can even get that back based on that specific icon. You can use the code function based on H1, H2, H3, and it will give you back those numbers again. So once you know that, we can create a pretty simple function. You cannot do it with regular functions. You could try with an array function, but unfortunately you would need the concatenate function, and concatenate does not work with arrays. So I have to make a VBA formula. I'm going to do that so later on I can test those two man-made functions. I go to Visual Basic, Alt F11, insert a module, and I created a function that I happen to call encrypt. I told you already it's a very simple algorithm, and I told you the reason why. I use two arguments, as input is the string that we want to encrypt, and B encrypt is a boolean, true or false, that is going to allow me, do you want to encrypt it or decrypt it? And I return a string. We declare a few variables. Then we reverse that input, that makes it a little harder to crack the code. And I use the S input as a string, because I'm going to change that into the reversed order of S input, and I capitalize everything. You can make it lowercase if you want to. Then we are going to loop through all the characters of the input for I equals 1 to the length of S input. We take the middle part of S input at position I, 1, and then position 2, 3, 4, and one character long. Then we are going to say to S character, we are going to add or subtract a certain amount of ASCII numbers. So I take the ASCII number of S character and add to it or subtract from it 20. But I do that with an IIF function. If B encrypt is true, then we add 20, otherwise we subtract 20. That is D. Then we store in SNew what we had already in SNew and the new character. And it does that until it has done that for all the characters. And then we say to encrypt, which is the name of the function, give me SNew what it is now after doing all those loops. You can also make that lowercase again if you don't like capitals. So now we can use that function very easily. We are going to put in there the function equals encrypt. And there is encrypt. Encrypt. It needs two arguments. It needs to know which number, comma, and we want to encrypt it, so we set the second argument to true, and we accept that formula. That is the encrypted version of that social security number. I double click it downwards, and those are the encrypted versions. Okay. So now I can basically delete column B. I don't want to look at those social security, and I don't want anyone else to see those numbers. But I cannot delete B yet, because this one looks in B, so I have to make sure that these are going to be replaced by values. So we copy it, paste it into itself, paste special, as a value. So now I got rid of the formula that I had to use in order to do so. Okay. Now I can delete, this one. And I still have, if I ever need to know what was the code, I can decrypt it. So I use the same function again, encrypt. But this time I use the encrypted version and decrypt it by setting the second argument to false. And that was the original code. So that was all based on this simple function that we had put in a module. When you do that, make sure that you save this file as a macro enabled file. Otherwise it will not run that macro anymore and will throw it away. Going back here, that works fine, but I have to do a lot of work. I have to again paste special the values here and then delete column B or whatever you want to do. So let's do it with what they call a subroutine or a method that we are going to create. So instead of typing that number in there, we are going to use two macros. One that I created a shortcut for, encrypt, and a decrypt macro. How you do shortcuts, I explained that in many of my other videos, so I'm not going to explain that again. So how will we do it? I'm going to show you what the sub encrypting one does. It is a sub this time, not a function. We declare a variable of the string type. Then we store in stext into that variable whatever someone types in an input box. We do a little bit of validation. If the length of that text is not 9 characters, I assume it's a social security number, that's always 9 characters, but you may have to change that, then go to the label again. I put the label again here with a colon, so then it takes you back to that input box, so you have to type it again and do a better job. If it's not numeric, then you also have to go back, for a social security number needs numbers. And then finally we are going to put in the active cell, the cell that we happen to be in, the encrypted version of stext, and encrypt it with true. That encrypt is this function. It can call that function directly. Okay. And we do something similar for decrypting. We declare stext as a string. We store in stext whatever happens to be in the active cell. We decrypt it by setting that to false, and then in a message box we show what the decrypted version is. It's basically very simple, but now I can just type that in there. I'm going to copy this one so I don't have to type that number. Control C or Control X actually. And now I do my shortcut. Control Shift E. Type your social security number here. I do Control V so I don't have to type it. And when I click on OK, it puts in that cell the encrypted version. So now I'm going to do the opposite. I would like to see for a moment what is really the code behind that. What is the social security number? So Control Shift D, and it gives me exactly the real decrypted number behind this one.